Hello everyone, welcome to the video demonstration of the morphology of the teeth. In this series, we shall be talking about the premolars. In the maxillary and the mandibular arch, we have two premolars in each quadrant. You have the first premolar, second premolar, that means four premolars in the maxilla and four premolars in the mandible. Let's pick up the maxillary premolars. The maxillary premolars have two prominent cusps, as you can see here. So that is one of the reasons why these teeth were called as bicuspids. They are in true sense not bicuspids, because if you see a mandibular premolar, it has the buccal prominent cusp. However, the lingual cusp is less developed. Whatever be it, each of the premolars are developed from the same number of lobes as that of the canines. So the premolar looks similar to that of the canine from the buccal aspect. However, when you look at the lingual palatal aspect, you can see that the marginal ridges are more horizontally placed and it forms a part of the occlusal surface. The marginal ridges of the canine were actually forming a part of the lingual surface. There are four lobes from which these teeth are formed. The central buccal lobe of the canine has a similar architecture or morphology in the premolar also. And this prominent buccal cusp is supported by two more lobes on either side. The lingual lobe is much more well developed to form the lingual cusp. This lingual cusp is slightly smaller than that of the buccal cusp, maybe a millimeter shorter. And this tooth very typically has a wider buccolingual dimension than that of the mesiodistal dimension. So hence, this is placed very much in between the anterior and the posterior teeth. That is why it's called as the premolar, teeth which come before the molars. The buccal cusp function similar to that of a canine in shearing and tearing activity, and the lingual cusp and the occlusal surface with a wider surface area acts as a chewing character also. It supports the masticatory process of that of the molar, but to a lesser extent. Overall, when you look at the tooth, the contact areas are much more wider than that of the canine, and they are almost at the same level on mesial as well as the distal size. The crown length is shorter cervico-occlusally compared to that of a canine, which is much more longer cervico-incisally. The premolars generally have one or two roots. The maxillary first premolar has two prominent roots, one buccal and a lingual root, whereas the mandibular premolars have a single root. However, all of these seem to have two root canals internally. When you look at the tooth from the buccal aspect, the mesial slope is longer than the distal slope. This configuration is opposite to that of a canine, in which the distal slope is longer than the mesial slope. These are some of the morphological differences that you see from the buccal aspect. In the next video, we shall describe the buccal aspect of the maxillary first premolar.